I love an obscure impression. And Matt, you have one of the better ones, which is it H.R. Giger?
H.R. Giger.
Yeah. Oh, Giger. I'm sorry, Giger. He is the guy that did the creature design for Alien,
yeah.
The Alien movies. And he's kind of famous in certain circles.
That's being kind.
Yeah. But how did you become obsessed with this guy?
Oh, I was watching the special features of an Alien film, and he said, he goes something like, "They articulate like a dinosaur." "Sometimes I eat eggs in the morning, but they are bruised purple varicose eggs with a yolk that runs like a pupil juice."
Is that really how he sounds?
Kind of.
I love that.
He did like Blondie album covers, and then he built a mic stand for the band Korn. You know, it's just all this like sexual gothic biomechanical stuff.
Oh my God.
So Giger's obsessed with sexual imagery, kind of a steampunk sexual energy, maybe?
Yeah, proto steampunk. But he's also strangely kind of innocent and sweet. Like he has a little cat and he.
So he says, "Dinosaur?
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur." What? You're obsessed with Giger the way I'm obsessed with Werner Herzog. You know, you ever watch his movie, the documentary about the bear?
Grizzly Man?
Yeah, Grizzly Man. I hooked into Werner Herzog because when he was talking about the bear, you know, the bear in the documentary.
Yeah.
I love that. And Grizzly Man, he keeps talking about how nature is madness. And then I noticed that in his, that as a theme with him is that nature is madness. And then he did some film about, is it Antarctica or something, where he's with the penguins? And there's a guy whose job it is just to watch the penguins. And so he's interviewing that guy about what it's like to watch penguins all the time. And the guy is saying like, "Yeah, no, it's pretty interesting. You know, it's pretty cool. I mean, I love watching penguins. They're kind of neat. They're pretty chill." And Werner Herzog is like, "But don't you think that living in this hostile environment, maybe in this blanket of white and the anarchy of nature, don't you think that the penguins are in danger of going mad?" And the guy is so great because the guy's like, "I don't know. I don't think so." And he's like,
"If they haven't yet."
Then Werner Herzog goes back to his narration and he's looking at the penguins. He's like, "You see them and you know that nature's just violence and chaos.
Oh my
in
God.
A swirling vortex of madness." And it's the most adorable penguins just standing around. And you realize, oh, that's how Werner Herzog sees everything, you know? Like he goes to Wendy's, to the drive-thru. He's like, I'll have a double cone. I want a freezy frosty with a double of a and a sprinkle of madness." He goes to like the Hall of Presidents. He goes on the It's a Small World ride. It's a small. You look at these children representing different nationalities, and you know, trapped on this island watching tourists go by on their boats, you know that they are consumed with anarchy and madness. It's a small world after all.
Oh my God.
It's a small world. The children from Iraq seem particularly insane.
Oh my God.
Trinidad and Tobago, they go especially mad.
I'm just doing Paula Tompkins' amazing impression of Herzog.
Trinidad and Tobago will soon be consumed by the bear, because only the bear understands their true insanity, being from Trinidad and Tobago.
Don't even get me started on Chad.
Oh, Chad. Chad the country? No, Chad Everett, the actor. Wait, what? Consumed with madness. Wait, Chad Everett? No one's referenced Chad Everett in years. Chad Everett was consumed with the madness of being a 70s star.
He sounds very Schwarzenegger-esque.
I know.
Sometimes.
One impression.
Yeah.
Anyway, that gave me a chance to repurpose my outdated Schwarzenegger impression.
Everybody wins.
Everybody wins. I'm a conservationist when it comes to impressions. I have like two of them. And I like to repurpose them as much as possible and not just toss them into a landfill like more talented performers.